Hello everyone, I am Dr. Anshu. Today we will discuss in detail the topic active voice and passive voice. Some specific rules that we need to follow in different tenses. We'll discuss it in detail. In the previous session, we had already discussed about voice, the types of voice, and what are the benefits of using or sharing information in active voice and passive voice, and how we can speak, what is the specific way, and what are the benefits or the merits of speaking in active voice and passive voice. So let us proceed further and discuss in detail today the specific rules to speak in active voice and passive voice. Active voice versus passive voice. In part two, today we will discuss in detail the rules for all the tenses. First of all, active to passive voice rule for simple present tense. Active voice and passive voice, the auxiliary verb that we use in simple present tenses is are, am. And the structure is subject, after that, first form of the verb, plus if you find as and es and the object, this is the structure that you will receive in active voice. And how will you change this structure? You'll write object in the first, and after that, helping verb or auxiliary verb is are, am, as per the requirement of the subject. And after that, third form of the verb, and don't forget to put by along with subject that you are keeping in place of object. So let us see example so that it can become much more clear. He reads a novel. This is the active sentence, and how will we change it into passive? A novel is object, and we have placed it here in place of subject, a novel. And after that, auxiliary verb is, and then third form of the verb, read. Then a novel is read. So in this way we will see active form. The subject always stays active, such as the professor teaches the students. So in the passive form, now the students have become subject. The students are taught by the professor. So the professor has become passive, although in active form, he was actively working. Another example, he does not cook food. Food is not cooked by him. So in this way, in simple present tense, these are the alterations that we will make. Active to passive voice rules for the present continuous tense. Active voice and passive voice, how will you identify? First of all, you may see the subject, and after that is RM. Then the structure will proceed with first form of the verb plus ing, and at last object. If you find this sort of structure, then you will change it into object plus is mr plus being plus third form of the verb, and then by, and then subject. So once if you'll observe the pattern later, you can always frame a sentence. Let's see one example. Isha is singing a song. So here we are changing and altering it in this way. A song is being sung by Isha. So in this way, Ravi is drinking a cup of tea. So a cup of tea has come in place of Ravi now. And tea is being drunk by Ravi. In place of drinking, we have replaced it in being, and after that, third form of the verb, drunk by Ravi. So these are the changes and alterations that we will make once if we wish to change present continuous tense sentence from active to passive. After that, active to passive voice rules for present perfect tense. So let us see the example first of all. Nitesh has challenged her. So we will make the sentence now from her. So in place of writing her, we have written she. So has been challenged by Nitesh. So if we see the auxiliary verb has and have, then along with that, we will keep be, double, and been when we are changing the sentence from active to passive. So this is the structure. These are the alterations that we are doing here in these sentences. One more example is they have cleaned the house. Now the house will come in place of they. The house has been cleaned by them. So this is the structure that we may follow once if we wish to change the sentence from active to passive voice. After that, active to passive voice rules for simple past tense. How do we write sentences in simple past tense? Let us see one example. Rima cleaned the floor. So if you see this sentence, now the floor is the object and it will come in place of subject. So it will come at first. The floor was cleaned by Rima. So how many changes we have done? Let us see. Subject plus verb, second form of the verb plus object. If you observe the structure, then you will change it in this way. Object plus was verb. After that, third form of the verb. And then don't forget to put by and at last the subject in place of object. Here in the picture you may see the teacher did not explain the answer. So if you find this sort of structure, you will change it in this way. The answers were not explained by the teacher. So this is the explanation that we are doing here when we are changing the sentence from simple past tense from active to passive. Voice. Active to passive voice rules for past continuous tense. The structure is like this. Subject, after that was, were, and then first form of the verb along with ing plus object. So if you see this sort of structure, you will replace it in this way. First of all, object, after that was, were, plus being, B-E-I-N-G, being, when you see ing, and then third form of the verb, and after that, don't forget to put by and the subject. The example sentence for this is Nikita was painting the wall. So obviously you'll keep the wall in place of subject, and was were being painted by Nikita. So these are the changes and alterations that we will do once if we see that it is past continuous tense. So first of all, you need to identify which tense. So if you see the structure, subject plus was were plus verb plus ing plus object, and it is past continuous tense. And in the passive, you'll do that. You'll write this object in place of subject, and then be form of the verb along with being, and then third form of the verb, and again don't forget to put by and the subject. So in this way you may see these are the alterations that we generally do once if we wish to change the sentences from active to passive. After that, past perfect tense. So the example sentences: Misha has had cleaned the floor. So we will reverse the sentence and start from the floor had been cleaned by Misha. So you may see if you find had, then also you will put PWN been along with had, and after that don't forget to put the third form of the verb. So example sentence, girl had clicked selfie. So in place of that, this sentence we will write it in this manner: the selfie had been clicked by girl. So these are the changes we usually do in past perfect tense. So after that, active to passive voice rules for future simple tense. You may see here, subject along with that verb, will or shall. First form of the verb and object. If you see this structure, you will change it into object along with that will, shall, be form of the verb. Third form, or you can say past participle, by, and then subject. So don't forget to identify first of all the structure and then change it accordingly. Example sentence, my parents will take us to the park. So if you are seeing as us here, you'll change it into we. We will be taken to park by our parents. Another example, Kriya will sew the bag. So we will start the sentence in passive. The bag will be sewed by Kriya. So this way we will make changes once if we wish to change from active to passive voice in future simple tense. In future perfect tense, first of all, let us identify. How will you identify this is future perfect tense? If you find the structure, subject, and in the verb, you'll see will have and third form of the verb. If you see the structure, then it is future perfect tense. And at last, if you find an object, then reverse it, replace it in place of subject and the subject in place of object. The example sentence for this is, they will have brought the toy. So they here is subject, will is be form of the verb, and that after that have brought third form of the verb, and the toy is object. So we'll write the object in place of subject, the toy will have been brought by them. So this is the change that we will make once if we wish to change active to passive voice from future perfect tense. So we will discuss some tips now for using voice. There are some specific sentences and then we need to alter, we need to identify what sort of changes we have to make once if we see the sentences that are made of, that can be framed by using let. If given sentence in the active voice is in the imperative form, to get the passive voice, you have to use let. Let us see one example. If you see the sentence, help me. So you will write here, let me be helped. So you'll see, open the door. So the door is in place of object. You'll keep it here in place of subject. But prior to that, don't forget to put let if it is an imperative sentence. Let the door be opened. So these are the alterations. And in the second tip for using voice, you'll see here, so these are the changes that we are usually making once if we wish to change. In another type of sentence, helping verbs like am, is, are, was, were, will, have, should, could, and will. If you see these helping verbs, if the question in the active voice begins with a helping verb, the passive voice must also begin with a suitable helping verb. First of all, we'll observe an example. Are you writing a letter? If the sentence is starting from helping verb, if it is an interrogative sentence, then you will make the changes as we have been doing, but still in place of are, now you are putting is, because a letter is a singular noun. So the object has come in place of the subject. After that, you may not forget to put being, being, because it is a present continuous tense written by you. So the past participle written, and after that by, and then you is subject that you have placed in place of object. And don't forget to put question mark if it is a interrogative sentence. One more example. Will you write a letter? So you'll write once again, will a letter be written by you? So rest all the altercations we are doing as per the rules and regulations that we had already discussed in the tense section. But if it is an interrogative sentence and it is starting helping verb, then we will keep the helping verb once again. And if the question begin with WH or how form, what, when, how, why, who, etc., the passive voice must begin with the same. Only who gets replaced by whom. So you will replace who by whom. Otherwise, the same question word will be repeated in the passive voice structure. So let us give an example. Why did you break the box? So you'll write, why was the box broken by you? So rest all same, why in place of why, and as here it is did, that means simple past tense. So we are keeping here was the box in place of subject, we are putting object, and after that past participle, third form of the verb, and don't forget to put by, and then subject. At last, don't forget to put question mark. So these are the specifications that we can always keep in mind once if we are changing the sentences that are interrogative. Interrogatives are usually framed by two ways. One, by the use of helping verb. Another, by the use of question word. Another tip is direct and indirect object. If a sentence contains two objects, namely indirect object and direct object, in the active voice, two form of the passive voice can be framed in that particular case. Let's see one example. She brought me a cup of tea. So here there are two objects, me and a cup of coffee or tea, whatever it may be. So you can frame the sentence by using I was brought a cup of tea or a cup of coffee by her. And even you can frame a sentence by a cup of coffee was brought to me by her. So when made passive, these objects, complements become subject, complement, and they come after the verb. They elected him their leader. So he was elected their leader. So these are the changes that we have to keep in mind once we are framing the sentence into direct, when we are identifying a direct and indirect object, then we will change in this manner. After that, cases where no passive form exists. Let's see one example. I eat, I am living here. So here, you must see that she has been writing a letter. If the sentence is in present perfect continuous tense, we will not change it. If the sentence is in past perfect continuous, he had been cleaning the house. Another example is future continuous. I will be filling all the documents tomorrow. One more tense, future perfect continuous. I will have been serving tea for customers at the hotel for 20 years by then. So if you see the sentences that are framed in these tenses, then we will not have any passive form for these type of sentences or these tenses. Intransitive verb which do not take objects. You have to see. I eat. I am living here. I have traveled by train. I went there. I waited for a long time. One more tip for using voice, gerund and infinitive. When used in passive form, gerund and infinitives are formed differently. Infinitive passive is formed as to be and after that past participle. It will be much more clear by the example, I want to shoot the tiger. The changes you may see, I want the tiger to be shot. So in the infinitive sentence, we'll use or we will change it in this manner. In gerund, passive is formed as being and after that past participle. So I remember my father taking me to the theater. So you can see this is a sentence and it will be changed in this manner that I remember being taken to the theater by my father. So this is the change that we have made. After that, you may see one more example tip for using voice when by is not used. Sometime you may see, you may observe that by is not used in almost all the sentences such as the dog was hit by with a stick. If the sentence is like this, then you'll see somebody hit the dog with a stick. So, a dog was hit with a stick. Even the sentence can be written like this. And use with a place of by, use with in place of by to talk about an instrument used by agent or subject. When impersonal passive in scientific and technical business writing, the emphasis is usually on the action or the process. So the by phrase is generally omitted. Let's see one example. One finds mosquitoes everywhere. So you'll change it in this manner that mosquitoes are found everywhere. You need not to use by here. So these are the changes and specifications, some tips that we had, that we have discussed. So these are the rules, and along with the rules for each and every tense, we are also aware of some tips for some specific situations, some specific types of tenses we had already discussed. And now we'll discuss in the upcoming session some more sentences that are based on different types of active and passive voices.